outsiders may compare them, then again the same kind of psychological problem would be there. So I suggest that just share your quality time with your kids, and while sharing the quality time, you can tell all these things then, that you all are very special, you all are divine, you are special, and every kid has different kind of caliber and capacity. So if anybody compares you, so never be victim of complexes, and these are the complexes. This is superiority complex, and this is the inferiority complex. And if you suffer from the superiority complex, then these would be the losses. And if you become the victim of inferiority complex, these would be the consequences or losses. So just share your quality time with them and discuss these kind of things. And if you will make their mind before, then they would not be negatively affected by that kind of comparison. Okay? And your second question is?
But how to make the kids self-motivated?
Self-motivating. Okay. For this, we should first try to understand their real talent, in which their natural talent and their natural inclination. We should always make them understand that profession is different and hobbies are different. Don't mix these two. Generally, sometimes kids mix these and they try to choose hobby as a profession. So clear this point. If he is good in singing, it may be your hobby, but it cannot be your profession. And in the later on, it may be converted to profession, but not at this stage. You should prepare yourself to be a scientist, a doctor, an engineer, whatever. So separate these two things, with hobby and profession. And second thing is, try to understand his qualities, his inclination, and his capacities, capabilities. According to those capabilities or capacities, suggest always him some options, because generally as you are knowledgeable about the different fields of the life, about the different branches, he is not so knowledgeable. You know better. He wants to be a doctor, but you know how different lines in even in the medicine or doctor line. So just by understanding his inclination and in our hobby, just put the options, 4-5 options, and let him give chance to select any option. And if you just if you will give option, then what will happen? He will think over that. And now child, they want to go in deep. They want to search the details in the net, whatever. So anyhow, he will be engaged in that. And in this way, perhaps, interest would be created. And try to inspire him to read more and more books or literature. This is very important. As playing is good for health, and other things are good for health, to make a perfect man, this quality is must. He should have a reading quality. He should have that kind of interest that I should cover this book, I should see this book. So from childhood, just try to develop the reading, means that kind of interest in your child. And if he would have this kind of interest, then his mental level would be of different kind, and he would understand so many things by reading good books. So we should have established this kind of hobby in our kid. This is must. So in this way, timely, he would be comparatively more mature and he would be able to take a proper decision. Others, maybe there are so many things, but I think these are the points. And the father kids, those are adamant, a stubborn. How to convince them to do good? So now at this time I don't want to go to the causes. Why he became adamant? If you will go to the causes, no, there are so many causes. But now the question is how to tackle, how to convince. So the simple thing is that, and try to understand this psychology also, that if you say something negative according to your child mentality repeatedly, if your child wants to play, example I am saying, and you say, no, you should study, study, study. So internally he wants to play, and we force him to study, then there would be battle inside him, and naturally he would not like us at that time, and he would be so adamant to fulfill his desire. Try this thing, that for try to understand this psychology. Everybody wants changes. Nobody can be stick for long time to anything. This is also human cycle. Do you agree with this? We want changes. Everybody wants changes. Nobody can stick to a particular thing for long time. So for whatever thing, child is adamant, no? Sometimes you can try to convince him in this way, just from your side, support him. Means if he is adamant for a right thing, and but that is not the proper time to do fulfill that desire, and you can do one thing for some time, you can just suggest, okay, I know you are fond of this, then okay, do this. I am with you. Try to understand. If you will support in this way 4-5 times, in the same according to his desire, then he would have different kind of faith about you inside him, and what would be happened? Timely, he would be less interested in that particular thing. This is natural. After enjoying the same thing, interest get shattered, kam ho jata hai. And in this way you would able to create good faith inside him, and when you find that this point is started, that now he is losing the interest in this thing, and now you have got the good faith, then suggest, no, I think you should do this. You can break with this policy. Have you got the point? Because now I don't know what kind of example is in your mind, but I think you can apply this policy.